said, clap on if you feel like a room without a roof. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Because I'm happy.
Welcome to this week's episode of Bucs Weekly with Orange. And boy, oh boy, it is a happy time here in Tampa Bay as the Bucs are finally off the losing stride with the big win over the Rams, 16-13 here in the Bay last week. And what can you say, folks? There's a lot of happiness going around here in Tampa Bay. You know, you hear it everywhere. I mean, what can you say? I mean, I know. That's not exactly. That's what it feels more like around here. Yes, that feels what it feels more like right here. Okay, everybody's happy. They're 4-5, still under 500, but guess what? Right? So thank you to the Falcons for losing last week miserably, and the Bucs getting off the slide, because now the Bucs are back in first place in control of their own destiny as far as NFC South, which is, to me, their only realistic path to the playoffs. They are this week on their way to Munich, Germany, for the first time in an NFL game in Germany. And we're going to say NFL, not NFL Europe. NFL Europe doesn't count. Okay, an NFL game itself, you know, not a preseason game, not a off-season league, an actual regular season game in Germany. First time in years versus the Seattle Seahawks, who are leading the AFC West, the NFC West. So a meeting of division leaders. So kind of gives it a little more luster than if they went there 3-6. Yeah, 3-6. So you're going to be 6-3 versus 4-5. Two division leaders. The Bucs desperately needed that win. Actually helped the Seahawks out, helped them create a lot more separation with them and the Rams. And they helped themselves out because it put them back in this position they need to be in. We'll talk about this a little bit more, but you know what it means? It's highlight time. So let's get to the highlights of this big win.
Someone made a fuss about it, said they ought to take the C off his jersey. As Stafford fires it downfield to an open cup. He beat him for 70 yards in the playoff game, and he's got another long one against the Buccaneers.
Oh my goodness, this is an incredible throw with Vita Vea bearing down on you and Cup running a perfect route.
52 yards it is. Oh, and it's blocked. The Rams smother it up at the 40. For the Bucs offense today, as Brady, oh, that's picked up right off the ground above it, I believe, for a catch for Godwin.
That's incredible.
They go Henderson, nice cutback. Yeah, it's a good room. And a beautiful in opponent territory since the first half last week. They had the long strike for a touchdown, so they hadn't run one on the other side of the 50. Just the first half against the Niners. It's Henderson again. He's got another big run.
First and 10.
Oh, they're going to bring him down. Finally.
Well, Aaron Donald imposed his will on the last.
Did he ever? There's the bootleg. And the deep throw. And the wide open cup. And ridden down by Edwards, but not until it was another big gain down the field for 34 yards. Here's a second and goal. And for the third time, Stafford is dropped. Raheem Nunez-Roches. This is 35 yards. And that kick is good. Matt Gay, who was drafted by Tampa back in 2019. From the 7. Looking for the win, and it's incomplete. And they get the flag. They've got the ball set up off the DPI at the one.
Quickly, don't want to try and scramble around or anything. Just throw it away if it's not there right away.
Here's the snap to Brady. Fakes to Fournette. He throws. It's caught. It's in for the touchdown. Incredible. Tampa Bay takes it.
And the Rams are dejected. They had this game won. This was a must win in a lot of ways for both teams.
what can you say? They're off the schlag. What can you say? It's much needed. Wasn't it exactly overly impressive? We saw both teams look very, very shaky. Plenty of times during this game, both of them struggled to run the football. Both of them had times where they did. More the Rams than Bucs. The Rams did have some big runs in there, as we saw in the clips. But we saw the Bucs win. We saw them pull it out. Tom Brady with the drive, Kate Otten on the play action, the goal line, much needed. Once again, we saw this offense only score 16 points. And now we know the Bucs scoring issue. We said these were mirror teams. Well, bizarre world lost because the Bucs pulled this one out. That's what we're doing. Rams Weekly, they're probably saying the exact opposite. Bizarre world won because we beat them. But nevertheless, okay, it was a much needed win. We're still seeing the struggles of this Bucs offense. And it doesn't get any easier. You got to go over to Germany to face a 6-3 team that's playing very well. It's playing very well defensively. It's running the ball. They're struggling to do is stop the run now. Reinforcements are on the way, Anton. Winfield comes back and a few other players. This is a game the Bucs can win if they play their best game. This is not an unwinnable game. However, it is the ultimate game because they're not playing well enough to beat a team that's playing that well. Okay, they beat a team last week that was playing just as poorly as they were. So it was a war of attrition for most of that game. And you saw they were trailing once again in the middle of the game. Okay, so gave the big play multiple times the cup. But luckily, he didn't score in that second one. So there are a lot of issues with this team right now. And still there, we saw it when they lay off after, you know, that team from Baltimore. That team from Baltimore came in here in Tampa and beat us on Thursday night. So we are really, really excited about this win. If you're saying you're not, okay, that's fine. I can understand you may not be as excited it as many fans are. Okay, but nevertheless, it is a much needed win for this team. There is no other way to say it. 4-5 going to Germany against 3-6, and looking up at some of the teams in your division, looking up at the Falcons, you know, still that would be a problematic at best. Okay, you have a chance now to go to Munich, play this historic game, and come out of there 500 after everything the Bucs have been through in these first 10 games. You have the ability to come out of it deep at 500, leading your division. Or you can go out there and play like you played the first 9 games, lose this game, and come out of there. And honestly, you'll probably still be in first place the way Atlanta is playing right now. But 4-6 doesn't confidence you. You come out there, big win, and come out and lose over in Germany. You know, then you get your bye week. So that's going to help get the team healthier, give you a chance to refocus, get away from the first 10 games. So into that bye, 5-5 is going to be a lot better going into it 4-6. That's a guarantee. But with that being said, we have to have this game. Going into it 4-6, coming out of that bye, and then having to make a run from 4-6 to not only hold the division, but try and at least ascend somewhere into a higher seeded position. As a division winner, you could face the highest wild card, which could be one of those teams from the East. which will most likely be one of those teams from the East. It's either going to be Dallas, the Giants, possibly even the Eagles, if somehow those two, one of those two teams overtakes the Eagles. All right, now this ain't the same Eagles team that you smacked in the first round of the playoffs last year. Like, come back, nevertheless, this is an Eagles team that's playing a lot better. They have a lot more weapons defensively. They are a lot more talented than when we saw them last. And most importantly, they score points. So Dallas playing a lot better with Dak Prescott now. They're scoring points. They're playing better defense. And honestly, the way we're playing right now without Gronk, and has been the piece that it haven't effectively replaced. Kate Otten's been good, but he's not the game-changing tight end that Gronk was. Gronk created problems in matchups, and teams had to scheme for it. Not coming up with game plans with Otten great. They're not. So this is a major factor here. What are they going to do about that? You can't. You work the receivers give you those matchups now because the tight ends aren't going to give you that. You know, but if you're going to face a team like Dallas, or you're going to face a team like the Giants, I think the Giants are the best coach. The Giants have that same issue. They don't score a lot of points. They play tough defense. If you get over on the Giants defensively and force them to beat you a lot of different ways, although Saquon Barkley is running the ball very well for them, that's a tough matchup, but it's the better of the three. If anything, they definitely want to see the Giants and not the Cowboys or the Eagles in the playoffs. So that's something we definitely want to look at this playoff scenario. But we are far away from that. We haven't even gotten to Thanksgiving yet. We're rounding the corner to that. But they definitely need this game this weekend to springboard, make that big playoff push, and nothing would be a better cure for their ills than to beat the first place Seahawks in Germany. Okay, so you're gonna have to get up early on this game. You know, if you're in church, have your phone out and peek in at it. You know, just don't turn the volume up. But you're going to want to see this game. You're going to be on pins and needles, hoping they pull this one out. And sometimes you just got to get a little lucky. It just is what it is. We're getting ready to go to a break in a little bit. First, what we do here from one of our sponsors. So, that being said, exciting news for the holidays right around the corner. Getty now has a gift with purchase promotion running on the site today through December 19th. Purchase $200 or more in Getty products and receive two Rambler 10-ounce low-ball tumblers in your choice of black, stainless steel, seafoam, or navy. Get your Getty today. So, we'll be back with more Bucs Weekly right after.
Enjoy 40% off site-wide. Vitable takes the guesswork out of feeling good. Get your own personalized daily vitamin pack safely delivered to your doorstep every month. Take their online quiz to find out which vitamins and minerals can support your personal needs based on your own diet and lifestyle. Hashtag only what you need, nothing that you don't. All vitamins are manufactured in Australia at the highest quality standard. Ingredients come in the best form for their absorption by your body. Enjoy 40% off site-wide using code NBS40 at checkout.
Night to get lucky, we're up all night to get lucky, we're up all night to get lucky, we're up all get lucky.
And let's face it, they're going to have to get a little wet. You want the Bucs in the playoffs, you want them at 5-5. The way we're playing on offense, they're going to need a little luck. So make sure you're there rooting for the weekend, because plain and simple, they need every bit of help they can get. Now, also, it's time to hear from our other sponsor. Let's talk about FanDuel Sportsbook. All fans, we have a great offer for you for one of our newest partners, FanDuel Sportsbook. Sign up for a new FanDuel account by using our special link located in our show's description, and you will get sweat bet up to $1,000. That means you can bet up to $1,000 on your first wager risk-free. FanDuel will give you the amount you wagered back in free bets. So go ahead, bet on your favorite team this Sunday, and even if they lose, you are taken care of. To claim this special offer, just click the link in the description and create a new account. Whatever you like, that's it. Win some money at FanDuel today. So, Munich, Germany. The Olympics, unfortunately, a very sad Olympic event. And most importantly, NFL regular season game in Germany is going to be in Munich. With your Bucs, first place Bucs, and the first place Seattle Seahawks. So, what can Tampa Bay do to win this game? All right, you got to stop the run. Okay, they've been having issues with that a lot the past few weeks. You saw Baltimore ran him out of Raymond James. The Rams tried to run him out of Raymond James. They just aren't considered the worst team running the football in the league. And you have a team right now that's running the ball extremely well. The rookie, Kenneth Walker, one of my favorite running backs in the draft, turning it on. He's pouring it on right now. So, you have to look at this team in a way they're playing run defense and be worried. Then you have to look at the way Geno Smith is playing with defense. And it's really up to these guys right here. Okay, if you think you needed them last week, oh boy, you really need them. You can't have Devin White getting pushed into the secondary in the running game. You can't. Feel back, you have to have him back to where he was before the concussion. Going to need Vita Vea and all those guys collapsing the pocket on play action passes up the middle, making Geno uncomfortable. They got to do everything on this week. They got to put up some points, and they got to make sure they do not let Seattle back in the game if they take an early lead, because they'll be in trouble. This team can score, and they will score, especially if they're running the football. So this is a big game. This is a really big game. Like you said, 5-5 or 4-6 going into your break. Thanksgiving right around the corner. You're in first place. I don't know if the way going with Atlanta, you'll be in first place going into this weekend because they're playing on Thursday Night Football. So this is a big matchup. It starts, like I said, up front. Line. It gets just continue to get worse and worse. Tom Brady up the middle. Okay, we know Goddard, he's out. Well, how about Nick Leverett? He's another one who's been missing practice because of injury. All right. So it's just not getting any better. The challenges that the hits keep on coming. You got the win last week, but you're going to really, really need to be better this week. You really are. And right now, Seattle can hit you with a lot of things. So I'm going to be on this defense. They've got to get the stops. They got to put Seattle in a bad way where this offense can get some points early and hopefully touchdowns early. And So hopefully signal didn't cut out. Hopefully heard everything. I'll repeat it just one more time. I said, oh, it's all about Geno Smith this weekend after, when it comes to the defense, stopping the run and making things uncomfortable for a career resurgence this year after, you know, being a backup for many years and getting to start early in his career in New York with the Jets. Unfortunately, that didn't work out. A lot of immaturity there. I was in New York when he was there. I had hard locker room mates. Eventually moved on, became a backup in several places. Same stadium with the Giants. He was out in Seattle as a backup for Russell Wilson last year. And got some starts last year. You see that he could play to that level. You know, didn't make a lot of big plays for them late in games last year to win games, though, which a lot of his critics relished with. They're not relishing right now. They're sitting there going, surprised because they thought they had him pegged as they bust. But right now, he is the savior in Seattle. And that savior could send you to under 500 and to your break in the first place by a fingernail. So, this offense, you need a running game to get going consistently. Not one, two, three big runs. Consistent runs. Early down run, putting them short consistently. Or first down, second down, first down. You can't have this many third down situations. You can't have the long third down situations consistently. They're just not consistent. Julio back last week, minimal impact. Minimal. Okay, nothing, he left the field injured again. Had a rest day this week. But Julio, this is the new Julio Jones. This is who he is, right? So you're not going to see the Julio Jones that we saw in Atlanta. That guy is officially left the building. We're going to take the time who they had to nurse through injuries, and now Tampa Bay is nursing him through injuries, okay? Getting minimal production for it, right? He is your number three. Right? A little clear to who he was. Mike Evans seems to be a little more focused and having less of the focus drops. Scotty Miller has been inconsistent. Less of a role, he's going to get less opportunities. Kate Otten's been the guy that stepped up the most. And they're going to need him for him to continue that, even when Brady gets back. So, this is going to be the key. Can they get some turnovers off the Seattle team? Can they stop the Seattle running game? If they could do those two things, they leave. If they don't, if they get a couple of turnovers, but they're struggling to stop the run all day, well, they may leave Munich 4-6, still hanging on to first place. But a couple of really bad teams in the division giving them a hard time and some tough games down the stretch. You're going to wind up holding on and getting this division in the end. And tough team in that first round of the playoffs that could oust you in one game. They really could. Right? Like I said, the best matchup if they face one of those three NFC East teams is the Giants. Right? Team that doesn't light it up offensively, play some tough defense, plays a lot of close games. That would be right up Tom Brady's alley. But then you're on the road after that. Okay, you're going to wherever. You could Philadelphia. You could go to whoever the number two seed is. Probably, if it's not Philadelphia, it's Minnesota. If it's not Minnesota, it's Dallas. It could be anywhere. All right? So, going back to Seattle. Think about that. Second round of playoffs. Go back to Seattle. So this is going to have a lot of moving parts and a lot of the things that we're seeing what the Bucs want because they're just not playing well enough offensively to threaten a lot of these teams. and it's something that has to be cleaned up in the second half of the season. We're starting to finally turn the corner in a way. And I think I said, like, we saw two teams that were basically the same team last week. You're not getting that this week. You have to step it up or you're going to get knocked back down. Buckify Burt would be happy with me if I picked the Bucs to win this week. You know, he'd be extremely happy. Am I picking a question because it's prediction time? Will we be having a party here in Tampa Bay? I don't know. I don't know. It's going to be early Sunday morning for a party. I'll tell you this much. Somebody will be leaving Munich happy on that long flight back. It won't go. Why? Because I'm going to pick Seattle to win this game. 27-16. Seattle Seahawks. So I think they'll happy flight back. Unfortunately, will be for the Seahawks. Now Bucs will come by before Thanksgiving. Unfortunately, we're just not playing well enough the way Seattle's playing right now. They're playing very, very good football. We saw them against our divisional matchup. And they are just a resilient team. What can you say? You know, it's just been that kind of season. It just has. You know? Yeah, I know. You're not happy. Nobody's happy with 4-6 here. They're not. Fact of the matter is, you'll still be in first place the way it's going. Okay? You're still going to be in first place, even if you come back 4-6 and still control your own day. Yeah, I know. It can't help but laugh. That's how weird a season it is for the Bucs. To think about that, after 10 games, they could most likely be under 500 and still in first place. That right there is just, what can you say? It's just that crazy. Okay, so 2017 Seahawks over the Bucs is my pick for Munich. It'd be a long flight home. It'd be a good bye week to get away from it all and reassess these 10 games and come back and try and improve where we are this season. So, I'll see you next week for the bye week edition. We'll recap the Munich game. We'll talk about the future of the Bucs going forward after this first 10 games, because we're not going to have a game next week. It's always the thing you have to buy for us. So, they'll get their bye week after this week. They'll get to rally the wagons, you know, get the sails back up. Get ready to make that big charge. So, it's time to fire the cannons. Go Bucs. Off to Munich they go. And I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.